Hello dear students and welcome in our biology session. So as we are discussing our point, that is what digestion in human being. Okay, and in our previous video we have discussed about the small intestine, how exactly the absorption processes happens in the small intestine, how the digestion is happen, how the absorption is happen, that we have seen in our previous video. Okay, so see here I am having the model of the digestive system. Up till now we have discussed about the different parts of a digestive system or the different digesting organ. Like that we have discussed about the pharynx and esophagus. Before that we have discussed about the buccal cavity, so we can say that buccal cavity. After that we have discussed about the pharynx and the esophagus. Then we have discussed about the stomach. With the help of the stomach we have discussed the different digestive glands, okay, which doesn't take the part in the digestion process, but they helps, they boost the process of digestion. Okay, so from the stomach the semi-solid, okay, or the partially digested food is comes into the next part of a digestive tract, that is nothing but what, small intestine. Okay, and about small intestine we have seen in our previous video, but in today's video we will discuss about the three major parts of a small intestine. Okay, there are the three major parts, or there are the three parts are present in the small intestine, because as we know the small intestine is the longest part of the digestive tract. Okay, so let's discuss about the different parts of a small intestine. So the small intestine has three parts, that is duodenum, which is called as what, anterior part. Next one is the jejunum, which is also called as what, middle part, means the middle portion of a small intestine. And the third one is what, ileum, that is what, posterior part, or we can say that the last portion of a small intestine. Okay, so in this way what we can say, the small intestine has three parts, that is duodenum, that is what, anterior parts, jejunum, that is middle part, and the ileum, that is what, posterior or the end portion of a small intestine. Okay, so as the food from the stomach enters into the small intestine, and as we know the small intestine is the connectivity between stomach and the large intestine. Okay, so the one end of a small intestine is connected to the stomach, while the other end of a small intestine is connected to the large intestine. Okay, so when the food is passes through these different three parts of a small intestine, different enzymes or the food get react with the different enzymes, which helps to digest the food. Okay, so let's discuss about the each part of a small intestine and which type of the enzymes are getting secreted by that particular part. Okay, so from the stomach the food comes into the first portion of a small intestine, that is nothing but what, duodenum. Okay, so the first food or the first part of a small intestine where the food comes, that is what, duodenum, or we can say the beginning portion of a small intestine. Okay, so the digestive juices and the enzymes act upon it in the duodenum. Okay, so the different types of the digestive juices which are secreted by the liver. Okay, so as we know the liver secreted the one digestive juice, that is nothing but what, bile, and which is stored into what, gall bladder. Okay, so that bile juice, also the juice from the pancreas, that is we are calling as what, pancreatic juice. So pancreatic juice and the bile juice comes into the duodenum and get react or get mixed into the with the food in the duodenum. Okay, into the duodenum. Okay, so what happens into the duodenum, the digestive juices and the enzymes act upon it in the duodenum. Okay, and that is the reason, because of this certain types of the enzymes in the small intestine, the food get digested in a small intestine. Okay, so the action of the enzymes produced in the small intestine digest the food. So in the small intestine different enzymes are getting mixed into the food, and that is the reason the food is getting digested in the small intestine. Okay, so here we have discussed the first portion of a small intestine, that is nothing but what, duodenum, where what happens in the duodenum, the different gastric juices or the digestive juices which are secreted by the liver and the pancreas, which are that, bile and the pancreatic juices are get mixed into the duodenum. With the help of that, certain enzymes are also getting mixed into the food in the duodenum. Okay, so the enzymes like trypsin and the lipase are getting mixed into the duodenum, and they also helps to digest the food. Okay, so this is about what duodenum, which is the anterior part of the small intestine. Next one we can say that is what jejunum. Okay, jejunum is the middle portion of a small intestine. So from the jejunum the food enters into the jejunum, and from the jejunum it goes into the third portion of a small intestine, that is nothing but what, ileum. Okay, so the jejunum connects the duodenum and the ileum. Okay, so in this way we can say that. And what happened in the ileum? The ileum, there are the different enzymes such as what, erythropoietin, maltase, sucrase, lactase acts upon the food. Okay, so in this way what happened in the ileum, the different types of the enzymes acts upon the food, and they try to digest the food, or they try to convert it into the simple form. Which are that enzyme? The enzymes like erythropoietin, maltase, sucrase, lactase, all these are the different enzymes which acts on the food. Now let's see which enzyme convert the food into which form. First we'll discuss about what, erythropoietin. Okay, so erythropoietin act upon the peptones and convert them into amino acid. Okay, so this erythropoietin is a one type of a enzyme which helps or which act upon some peptones. Now peptone means what? These are the simple soluble substance or like a of proteins. Okay, peptones means what? These are the simple and the soluble form of proteins. Okay, so this erythropoietin acts on the peptones and convert them into the amino acid. Okay, next one enzyme is there, that is what, maltase. Okay, so this maltase, what it happens, this maltase break down the maltose sugar and convert them into the glucose. Okay, so this maltase enzyme break down the maltose sugar and convert them into glucose. Next one is there, sucrase. Okay, next one is there, that is what, sucrase. So what is the role of the sucrase? This sucrase converts the sucrose, okay, convert the sucrose into the glucose and fructose. All these are the different types of carbohydrates. Okay, all these maltose, glucose, fructose, sucrose. Okay, all these are the different types of a carbohydrate. Okay, so see, this sucrase act upon the sucrose and convert them into the glucose and fructose. Okay, now the last one enzyme is there, that is what, lactase. Okay, so this lactase help, this lactase enzyme helps to break down the lactose sugar and then convert them into the glucose and the galactose. Okay, glucose into the galactose. So all these are the different enzymes which get mixed with the food in the last portion of a small intestine, that is nothing but what, ileum. Okay, so in this way these are the different gastric juices or the digestive juices and different enzymes helps to digest the food in the small intestine, and that is the reason the digestion and the absorption of the food is happens into the small intestine. Okay, so see, every time we are discussing about enzymes, enzymes means what, these are the biocatalyst. Okay, which doesn't take part in the reaction, but they helps to increase the speed of a reaction. These are the chemical substance which boosts the chemical reaction. Okay, so in this way different enzymes, gastric juices helps to digest the food in the small intestine. Okay, so see, up till now we have discussed about the ingestion, which is the first process of digestion. Then we have discussed about the digestion. Then we have discussed about the absorption. The digestion and absorption, both these happens in the small intestine. Okay, so this is all about small intestine. We will meet in the next video with the next point, and this is the time to tell you goodbye for today. Thank you.